The connection between Mocha Pro and SynthEyes is even stronger than ever. So if you need to take 2D tracking data from Mocha Pro into SynthEyes, or taking a full 3D solve and refining it inside of SynthEyes, then it's never been easier. My name is Ben Brownlee. Let's take a look at how we do that. So here is our first shot, which I've already solved, and I've also added in a bit of proxy geometry in here as well, in the form of this house plus a couple of trees. If we take a look at the 3D objects, you'll see that I have, in addition to the visible feature points, auto features, I have a lot of invisible ones as well. All right, let's export this camera data out to SynthEyes now. So I click on export camera data and I get to choose a SynthEyes project, just as we have done before. I'm going to save this out and I'll just save it out to a SynthEyes projects folder. And let's open that up now in SynthEyes itself. There's our project, and it imports in with the models and all of the features that we had, whether they're visible or invisible. If you don't want these coming over from Mocha Pro into SynthEyes, then you should trim these in Mocha Pro before exporting out the project. I'll just come quickly into my solver, and you can see my HPX error is currently about 3.9, almost 4 pixels. So if I clean up my trackers, disable some of these bad frames, fix all that up and hit refine, then I can take my HPX error all the way down there and start to work further inside of SynthEyes, reconstructing the geometry or doing whatever I need to do for the final shot. Being able to take 2D tracking information from Mocha Pro into SynthEyes is also really important. So we could be working with planar surfaces as well, so all the four points plus a center point, or the PowerMesh data. So we can take out a swarm of 2D data points as we have here. And then even though we haven't turned those into 3D points in the Mocha camera solve, we can use these still in SynthEyes to then turn those into 3D points there. So if I have my layer selected and come to export track, I can take this out to the 2D SynthEyes tracker data, and that comes out as a SynthEyes project again. And let's look at this in SynthEyes. So within SynthEyes, I have my camera already tracked. Let's turn off that spline visibility. And now I want to bring in the 2D data from Mocha. If we don't already have any data inside our SynthEyes project, we can just open up that saved project, or I can come in and merge my 2D tracking data into this project here. So I'm going to hit OK. Make incoming tracker names unique. Well, yes, please. I think that'd be very nice. And then if I look at the hierarchy view now, we've got my camera that I already had, plus a new camera, which hasn't been solved, but does contain all of these nice juicy trackers. So if I come into my camera one, once again, I'll add a moving object into there, and I can just transfer all of those trackers using the hierarchy view and just click and drag up into my object. And then we can solve our points, do whatever we need to do with them, and work forwards in our SynthEyes project. So that's a way how we can start to use Mocha Pro data directly inside of SynthEyes, whether that's 3D data we want to refine, or if it's 2D data that we want to add into our SynthEyes workflow. It's really easy now to get that Mocha data over into SynthEyes. If you'd like to learn more, then join us over at borisfx.com. You're also more than welcome to head over to the forums or to our Discord channel, links in the description below. My name is Ben Brownlee for Boris Effects. I'll see you again soon.